Hi, Hiram here again. I want to do another boil test with this fondue set that I got from Goodwill. I'm going to use a standard pot this time to see what the boiling times are like. For those of you that may be misunderstood, what I'm saying is I think something like this you can get real cheap and would be good to have at home in your emergency kit that you can use, you know, like when the power goes out, when there's a storm. You can use something like this in your house relatively safe. You know, now, if you're a knucklehead or something, I wouldn't suggest you use it. But any half-sane person should be able to use this safely in the home because it's for being used at parties. There are different forms of this. This one's kind of cool. I just noticed the other day, if I take the burner out, the large Trangia fits in there perfectly. Pretty cool. Although I do think that the burner that came with it is decent enough. I mean, it's a pretty decent little burner with regulator on here so you can set it to a sort of a simmer. Let me get this started. This takes a little while to heat up for the test. I have alcohol in here. Oops, let's see if this is burning. Yep, slightly. Gotta watch that I don't blow it out with my talking. It does seem to need time to warm up. I'm gonna push that off to the side here. Wanna show you another one that I got from Goodwill. This was a s'mores pot, a s'mores burner for making s'mores, but I thought it was pretty cool. It's got the same kind of burner, except in this case, it looks like it uses cans of Sterno, but it has the same lid, the same regulator, but just uses cans of Sterno, it looks like. Has this cool little stand that it fits in, and then this grill that fits on the top of that. So I think this is going to be kind of handy. I think I paid $1.25 for this. Plus the other paraphernalia that I gave back to him. Hey, let's see what this burner's doing. Not yet. It does seem to be a slow warmer. The last time I did this boil test with the original pot that came with this, it's a very heavy steel pot with enamel on it, and I mean it's heavy, so it took quite a while for it to finally heat up. I think it got to boil in 12 minutes and 12 seconds. Okay, the burner, just wasting some time here. This burner looks a lot like some of the camp stoves people have made. Down in the bottom it looks like insulation with a wire covering over the top. Okay, it's starting to get out. It's getting hot. It really gets a good burn, good flame once it gets really started. Okay, now I'm going to use my standard pot number one. I have 2 cups of water in here that's now sitting at 56 degrees, and I'll take the time from when it gets to 60. That's 57 degrees now. It's only 3 degrees off. And you can see that you can kind of regulate the flame. Okay. Let me put the water on and start the timer. Okay, there we have 210, 211, 212 at 833. Boiling water at 8 minutes 33 minus the 17, so it would be about like, what, 8 minutes 15 seconds or so, give or take. Not bad for just a cheap little burner. Not bad. Now this is a much nicer flame than when I started. That could be a difference as to why it took so long. But previously, with the pot that it came with, it was 12 minutes and 12 seconds. By adding my standard camping pot, it went down to 8 minutes 33 minus 17 seconds. So, I suggest going to Goodwill, even though it's not the fastest thing in the world. Pretty cheap, pretty handy. When you need it, it'll be good to have. So thanks for watching. I look forward to your input, questions, remarks, helpful suggestions. And as always, watch for my buddy Max. Bye now.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then.
Good boy, Max.